This morning my guest is Michelle Marshall, and I've invited Michelle here this morning because, as I talked earlier on the show, at Art Camp, we want the kids to know that they have the power to be superheroes, that they can make super decisions and super choices. And so our whole Art Camp this year is geared to finding the superhero in you. And one of the activities that we did was the kids got banks, and they got to decorate their banks and put their names on their banks, and then go home and collect pennies and nickels and dimes and quarters. And, you know, I had kids tell me stories where they went and they raided Dad's car and took all the change. And one mom said she has like a little stash that she just keeps extra coins in the kitchen, and all of a sudden the coins are all gone. Ask first. But the kids filled their banks and they brought them back last Friday. And there was a lot of coin to count. And we were amazed that the kids came in with $289 worth of pennies, nickels, dimes, and quarters. And we counted it all on Friday. So we knew when the kids left at 3 o'clock, basically how much money the kids had and had raised in just that group of 60 kids. So part of being a superhero, the kids were asked to make a decision. They got to choose where they wanted their money to go. And we explained what each organization did, where they were located, and then as a group, they got to vote on where they wanted the money to go. And they voted on Storybook Acres Rescue Farm that Michelle runs on Creek Road. So I am going, we rounded it off. It was no sense giving $290 when we could give $300. So Michelle, here's $300 from just the first week of our camp. Now we're not sure what the second week, they bring their banks in tomorrow morning and we're not sure where that's going. But the first week is going to go to Storybook Acres.
Thank you so much.
For those people that don't know what Michelle does, and she is an angel sent from God to take care of disabled animals, Michelle's going to tell you something about her farm and then update us on some of the animals that we know about, like the two little goats.
Mary.
And Mary. So tell us, Michelle, what your farm is all about.
It was started 14 years ago. And what the purpose of it is to take severely handicapped farm animals that would normally be put to sleep, animals that are missing legs, experienced extreme trauma, that need a place for the rest of their life. Mm-hmm. And they came to live on, we take them from all over the country. Mm-hmm. They come and we make artificial legs. We have wheelchairs for, they go from small to large animals that if they can't walk, it gives them the chance to still go out in the pastures. Mm-hmm. We have, the 10 acres is fenced in. There's three barns on the property. The animals all live together. We don't have any pens. Mm-hmm. We don't have anything. All the animals, the pigs, the goats, the donkeys, the horses, they all live in one place. Mm-hmm. They come and go as they want. We have orchards for them. I plant vegetables for them. And they're free for the rest of their life. None of the animals come to Storybook Acres to work for a living. Mm-hmm. They don't have to have their meals a half hour late because mm-hmm. people come to see them. Mm-hmm. This is their home, and anyone that comes to Storybook Acres is the guest. Mm-hmm. That's how I treat it. And I take care of them until they die. The amazing part is most of the animals live over the normal life expectancy of the animal. Mm-hmm. We don't do things like to promote them to live a long time other mm-hmm. than, you know, just taking care of them. Our biggest thing is keeping them free of pain, mm-hmm. keeping them as mobile as they can mm-hmm. so that they live a happy life. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's
very
what
good.
Our purpose is.
Very good. And before we came on the air, well, you and I talked on the phone yesterday, and Michelle is in need of some help. You're in need of some volunteers to come help.
Yes.
So if you have what it takes to come out and help Michelle feed the animals, clean up the animals, talk to them.
Oh, talk to the animals,
you
brush
know,
them.
Yeah, brush them, just give them some care.
What I really need now, because we're over, way, way over mm-hmm. our quota, I have animals that need help. They have to be whirlpooled.
Uh-huh.
some of them should be whirlpooled every other day. Mm-hmm. Because I'm there alone and they are three sizes my size, mm-hmm. I have to wait till I get a volunteer to help me take the artificial legs off and things.
And to do that.
So someone that can pop cookies in a goat's mouth mm-hmm. while I work on their legs mm-hmm. would be handy.
Would be handy.
Would be very mm-hmm. handy.
So if you can help Michelle, Michelle, how can they give you a call or can they stop by?
They could call me.
Okay.
And we also have our own website, which is okay. storybookacres.org.
Okay.
You can contact me through there. The phone number is 440-228-7990.
Okay. All right. And we'll give that number again toward the end of our segment. Okay. Because Michelle can really use some help with the animals. And I know some of you are home and you're looking for something to do. And this is a way to make a difference. Just give Michelle a call. And you are located on Creek Road.
Right on Creek Road.
Right on Creek Road. Yep. If you drive down Creek Road, you will see the sign. You can stop in and talk to Michelle. She can actually show you some of the tasks that need to be done. But she could really use your help in taking care of these animals. And I know Michelle gives them a wonderful home. So if you can help her at all, that would be great.
Yeah.
We also talked a little bit, Michelle, about something that's been happening that you need to stop happening.
To stop happening.
So let's talk a little bit about that.
The animals on Storybook Acres, the animals that the rescue is for, are severely handicapped mm-hmm. animals. We've had a rash of people just dropping animals off. Goats, three goats at a time, in the middle of the night, just leaving them. Unfortunately, some of the other animals, when they're in a wheelchair, mm-hmm. one of the healthy animals knocked them in the pond. Mm-hmm. They take their food. Mm-hmm. I don't have the facilities to separate healthy animals right. from sick animals. It also takes my time away from the ones
absolutely.
That need. Dropping animals off, I had to go to the hospital that's recently backboarded mm-hmm. for a concussion because of all the cats that people have dropped off. I actually tripped over them mm-hmm. and knocked myself out. So, you know, when they're dropping animals off, mm-hmm. it's really becoming a problem.
Yeah. Please don't do that. Please find out homes.
Please don't drop animals off.
Right, right. And if you have a healthy animal, that's what the APL is for.
Yeah.
You know, take them to the APL. Call the APL. You know, call, I don't know who you call, but
I don't know.
But dropping your animals off at Storybook Acres or in the woods or at a neighbor's house or going down, that is not the way to do it.
Because you don't know that, we have a dog now that we accidentally found mm-hmm. that was tied to our sign in the front yard in the heat.
Yeah.
Luckily, we seen him before he died.
Right.
You can't do that to the animals.
No, that's not fair at all. Absolutely.
And if there's anyone who's looking for a pet goat, mm-hmm. I have healthy goats mm-hmm. that I would be more than happy, you know, I don't want, the thing is once they come, even though they're healthy and mm-hmm. I never agreed to have them come, once they come to Storybook Acres, they're a bit on the spoiled side.
Yeah.
So to take them and just tie them up mm-hmm. or not feed them, only let them live on grass, mm-hmm. they won't know how to function that way. They have to be, well cared for, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. but
if someone comes to the farm and they would like to adopt a goat, you're going to tell them how to take care of that goat.
Yes.
How you've been taking care of that goat, what that goat is used to, what that goat needs.
They're used to a lot of attention from humans. Mm-hmm. They're used to breakfast and dinner. they're used to being touched. Mm-hmm. So they're wonderful for pets, mm-hmm. and they're healthy. And they're
right.
wonderful animals.
Right. They need homes.
When they start butting one in a wheelchair, it doesn't work real well.
Right, right. And of course, they're healthy.
Yeah, they want to play.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. They want to play. They don't understand that, you know, they're not. And they're not as, they're way more aggressive probably toward food and everything than the other animals are.
Yeah, so you don't know
who can get there first.
Yeah,
the goat with four legs or the goat with three.
Right. And you don't know what they came from.
Right.
Like Mary, for an example, mm-hmm. we had Mary here when Mary was so sick. Mary went without food for so long. She was mm-hmm. emaciated. And to this day, Mary is very tiny, short-wise, because mm-hmm. she was stunned, but very fat. People always think Mary's pregnant. Because Mary is so afraid of going without food.
Yeah.
You know, Mary just, she aspirates just about trying to get food in.
Right.
And she's never been hungry,
yeah.
you know, since I've had her. But there's something that happened to her many years ago, and
yeah, it's not gonna change. Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
And I told volunteers, I know she gets on your nerves, but deal with it. She has emotional problems we have to deal with.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Well, you know, again, Michelle needs some help with volunteers. She also could use donations. If you would like to donate to Storybook Acres. I know we just haven't been on in a while. We haven't seen you for a while. And that's always, always something that she appreciates. So please keep that in mind.
Yeah.
You know, step out, help. Help if you can. And again, monetary donations. We're just thrilled that the kids picked you this week. Last week, and you know, this week we're going to do the same thing. We're going to offer them the opportunity to give their money to several different organizations, and part of what we're doing is they get to make that decision where they want it to go. So I don't know. We don't know where it's going to go next week, but we are so proud of the kids for making this decision.
Oh, I am. I was getting very down because I've had some medical problems, which has made it a little more difficult to take care of the animals, and I was at the point where, am I supposed to be here? Am I supposed to be doing this?
Yeah.
And then when you see little children voting that you want, then you feel like, no, I do have a purpose.
Yes, absolutely.
What I'm doing is important.
Yes, it's very important.
It meant the world to me.
Yeah, very good. Well, we're very happy about this, and I know it's going to go to good use. So
it will go for the medical bills, except for some of it has to go for a treat. They always get treats.
Yes, we talked about this. Yes. Has to go for treats.
Yes, they have salad bars, so I will be going to the bread store and giving them a treat this afternoon.
All right, very good, very good.